Hi and welcome, Vitigo Property Guides is on the street today, and actually I decided to take a short video, not in the property, not in the flat, but to go with you on the road. And now we are in Dahar and we will move to Magawish, so maybe it will give you a chance to understand also how everything is connected with each other, how it's moving here. So I will stop to speak now, or I will speak, but I will let you look in the street. We are here in Dahar. To your right you see the vegetable market. A very popular, very nice place. Everyone should visit it once he's here in Hurghada. And we just leave the center traffic of Dahar, the old town of Hurghada. As you see, it's very crowded like always here. The traffic is crazy. But this is what we love in Hurghada. Even now we are located here on a let's say local street. It's partly local, but already also many Europeans find their ways here, because once you have property here, you live here, you will start to move away from the promenades, and for sure you purchase and you get your needs mostly from here. This is another street, and let me tell you, from now you will find everything you need. You will find it here, from electric items, from clothes, shoes, decoration, whatever comes in your mind, you can find it here. Even handcrafters, carpenters, and facilities for plumbing, electric, lighting, furniture, everything. It's a very crowded street. It's almost a few kilometers long. I don't want to tell something wrong now. I don't know the exact number, how many kilometers, but it's a long street. And if you search for something and you explore it by feet, it will take one day from you, because you will find a lot of nice things. Also the side streets from the main Nasser Street is very interesting. A lot of specialists for different categories, you will find them there with their shops offering their service and products. So take a look. Even if you purchase with us your furniture, we collect small items and everything. We collect it from several places, mostly here in Dahar. And the area, actually, it's as I told you, it's an old city, the old part of Hurghada. It's very local, but many Europeans also find their ways. We have the big supermarket, the mall, the 7-star mall with spinnies inside. It's just upcoming. They are facing the opening very soon. We are now in May 2020, so we expect this year the mall will be ready and very frequented. Also, we have a lot of upcoming projects and developments right beside the street, behind the street. Left you see the water tower, and if you follow the streets beside, you will come right away to Arabia area, where you will find also the new city mall, which is also a very fantastic place to visit, by the way. In another video we will show it to you as well. And now we come to something what the Egyptian and the Hurghada government make it new. This is the promenade on the Nasser Street. So they built between the two direction streets, they built this promenade what you see now on my left hand. And it's a really fantastic area and a recreation area. So the people can come with their families, with their kids, and enjoy the time there. It's brand new. They just finished it end of last year. So you have some play toys, you have some sitting areas, you have something to drink also, and it's protected. But between the two main streets, it's really crazy. But nice idea. And in the beginning of this promenade, they have a big theater. Let's say like this. It's something like a stage. It's reminding somehow a little bit the Italian Colosseum, the Rome Colosseum. And you have a center stage, so also some events can happen there and happen already before. This is what you see right in front of us with yes, here left. So now you see one side of another street, very popular, local and public street, which is very interesting, everyone should know it. And we start to move now from another street to El Corso, where is the airport located, the banks is located. Also here you see this connection road, you see that we have a lot of activities. The government renew even this area, this street. Actually in the last 2 years, so let's say in the last year plus this year, we have a lot of activities from the Hurghada government to recreate the areas, to develop them, to upgrade them, to make them more nice, to build more areas where families can come together, where they can spend their time, where the people can sit. It starts to be really clean. We have good activities with rubbish development, with the company Hepka, which is private financed and supported by the government, which is a very, very big step in the general quality, for the general quality. Point on your right hand, you will find the El Hegaz Road. This is a street where also a lot of professionals is located. You have a lot of services for car and tradings, warehouses. It's also once you live here, it's interesting to know where is El Hegaz Road to orientate. Also not less interesting, to my right hand now, it's a big hospital, the Nile Hospital, which is directly located on the airport road. Actually now we are on the airport road. This is the Nile Hospital, which they renovated in the last year, fully upgraded. So we already come to the airport. Here is the beginning of the airport. you can say this street at this location is the starting point for every visitor come from overseas, from abroad, just to Hurghada. He will start from here, you can say. And from here, any journey begins. Once you arrive with your plane, you leave the airport, this will be the first place you see it, and from where you are, journey begin. See, because it's behind the trees. This is Mubarak 5, the area called Mubarak 5, and New Kausar. Actually, here is many areas called by Mubarak, by the last president, and they make a lot of activities. Mr. Mubarak and his wife, so especially his wife, she make a lot of activities in the social and family area to build good social foundations for families. So they name several areas by Mubarak, and it's counted with numbers, but it's not mean that for example Mubarak 1 is directly connected to Mubarak 2. No, it's really widespread, and even me till now I cannot understand why which number it's located where, but you just have to know it. So here left from us is now Mubarak 5, New Kausar, El Kausar itself, where which built at the moment the main center of Hurghada. This is a developed part of the city. So we will break very quick because we have. So now we are back. The police control is passed, and we just missed few meters. Don't worry. So actually here we are still in front of the airport, and we pass the first gate, let's say, like this new international airport. Now we are going straight still the airport road, and we are passing now Steigenberger and all of these hotels on our left hand. Looks fantastic here, right? It's a good starting point for everyone. So actually where we will come now, the next area, it will be Mubarak 6. Mubarak 6 is an area with mostly double twin villas, which is already also, let's say, infrastructural, it's done. It's finished from the government, so the owners of the villas, they care about the shape and the look, and how the city part inside is developed. So this is here starting, Mubarak 6. We have villas, we have some small compounds and resorts. And if you will jump now, for example, look left and you jump over this, you will find Intercontinental area, which is directly connected to El Mamsha Promenade, connected to Steigenberger Promenade, and after Intercontinental area you will find in this direction Magawish. Later we will try to create for you a map which will make it more easy for you to orientate and to see how Hurghada is built and which area parts is located where. mostly you learn it by experience. But for this you have to stay here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 years and more to understand how everything is connected here together and when you pass which area. To your right hand, for example, now you see the Mubarak 6 villas, which is very common and popular. And in front of us, this is Intercontinental, a part of Intercontinental area. Also with Al Khaya Hospital. So we have really enough hospitals here, just to take the chance to highlight this also. We have enough hospitals, we have more than enough pharmacies. This is the street which goes through Magawish, through the hotel areas with the Albatross Hotels, Aladdin, Alibaba, Jasmine, and it brings you direct to the popular Senso Mall, Hurghada Aquarium as well. So now on the left hand, it's Magawish, as well on the right hand. So we arrive in Magawish now. And here we have the same thing. The government says in Magawish we have a lot of villas, mostly it's villas. And so the government say, okay, in this area the people who live here, they can afford to live in a villa. So it's not our obligation for the government to do the streets, the development of the streets and the development of the areas. This is something that can be managed by the owners of such properties. So for my opinion, I find it quite fair, because anyway, we have enough people that are living near the hunger, and these people should benefit from the efforts of the government. And if the government say the people who can afford to live in a villa, they can come together in a community, they can order the work, and we as a government, we will supply this work, but the people, they will pay for it. So for my opinion, it's quite fair in this environment we have here in Hurghada. But the people, they cannot come together, so we have here very bad streets. The main infrastructure from the government, like electricity, water, and the supplements, it's done. So we have some lightning in the streets, we have some bad water management and all of this stuff. So you can say, from the view of the government, this area is developed. The rest is cosmetic, which belongs to the owners here. It's a very nice area, but you need, for example, you need a car to live here, and you need to like this lifestyle. It's something very specific, very for its own. Either you like it, either you hate it. It's very easy. So, dear friends, that's it from my side, from our side, Vitigoc Property Guides for today. We just thought it would be nice to take you on a trip and between all the properties we show you, and we hope you enjoy it. Don't forget to comment. We are really welcoming any conversation with you, and don't forget to check our other videos. Don't forget to subscribe our channel. We will do our best to serve you with really nice content. And if you have any ideas and wishes, what you would like to see, what we should introduce to you, share it with us. We are listening to you. Vitigoc Property Guides on the way for you.